Hi, this is Bibi. It's like, to me, from what I'm getting, this the voice is called, the voice I'm hearing, that I know for sure now, it's not psychic, it's just technology. It's like every time she does something, like right now, every time I touch anything in my house, there's an electric shock. Electric shock. If I pass by my stove, if I touch the doorknob, if I touch the switches to flip them on and off, it's happening. Anything with a metallic protrusion or anything that has a metallic surface, like even a screw, a nail, so anything at all. Which means that she probably took out the grounding wire for the house. Now, how she knows to do this, maybe she's an electrician, I don't know. Maybe they hired people to do this. They watch what they did and they're just copying to cut down on expenses, I guess, I don't know. So she can go into the crawl spaces now and she can take care of business herself. Like I said, this woman has one goal, and that goal is to put me 6 feet under. Now, I don't know what this couple did to me. I don't know what they have done. And I don't know if she's doing this out of fear, that if I'm alive, that somehow something they did will be found out and they will end up in jail, that they will, heaven forbid, have to pay for their crimes. This is all about not willing to pay for the crimes that they committed against me. And at this point, I would say against me, because I seem to be the targeted one in this. Who else? Unless there are other people out there that they're targeting as well, and I don't know. But she seems to be focused on me primarily. Like she has something against me, and it is very strong. Now, she mentions my family a lot. She mentions my family a lot. Now, again, I think I mentioned this before. Last year, I have a cousin that is my mother's brother's daughter. And she lives back in my homeland, my home country. She has a 17-year-old son. And she said last year, I don't know how someone contacted him, if it was through Facebook or where they contacted him. And they were sending him some package. And they wanted $100,000 of that country's currency. I don't know if they were trying to see if they have the money or how they would come up with the money, or if they were sending them some stolen property. My guess is they were sending them some stolen property to implicate them in something. And when that happened, I guess the boy, my nephew, told his mother, which was my cousin, and she took over the texting and said, do you know this boy is, say, 17 years old? He's a minor. And he doesn't have that kind of money, and she's a policewoman. She's not a policewoman, but she said so, that I will report this and get you all locked up. To which the person responded, you better not tell anyone, or if you tell anyone, I will hack your head. Now, bearing in mind, listen to what I'm saying, I will hack your head. I specifically asked my cousin, did they say hack off your head, like chop it off? She said, no, hack your head. What do you call what they're doing to us? It's head hacking. They're hacking our heads. Now, that's what I'm saying. This woman is targeting me. She's targeting me. Now, one of the things that I mentioned is that whoever was corresponding with the boy mentioned that they will send the package that they wanted $100,000 for. They wanted the package. Every time I'm talking here, you see my cat's throwing up. Whatever is in the air, they're using it to fuck with her too. This is to show power. She's showing how much power she has, that she can kill me or the cat at any time. Yeah, more power to her. I don't know what else to tell her. But I will die talking about what's happening to me. I'm not going to shut my mouth. But to get back to what I was saying, is now she'll go in the litter box. She doesn't have a choice. You want to throw up and you want to poop at the same time. Happens a lot. She's gone in the litter box. Story of our lives, me and the cat. She has a lot of power. Yay, gang stalkers. Yay, defend them. But anyway, the address that the person who was texting my cousin's son gave him was an old address. An old address that the boy doesn't even know. This was when his mama was single digits. This or within the vicinity of the same area was an old address. They were going to send a package to that address. They were going to send a package to that address. Now, how in the world? Now, this is a third world country. They're now getting cell phones and computers, and now, you know, it's becoming like a cell phone is becoming almost a household item. It's not a country that when I left in 1999, that was, you know, very technologically inclined in every household. Not at all. We were now learning about cell phones and getting them. Not every home had even a landline. So how would they know? How would they know so far back? Now, bearing in mind, when my mother came to this country, my cousin and her dad and her brother and their mom was living at that same old address. So when my mom came to this country, she would have had that address written down on a piece of paper. Would she have communicated with them? She would have had that address written on a piece of paper. So when she died, or before she died, she gave an aunt right here, who was living here at the time, she gave her all the papers she had. All her pay, you know, like maybe her passport, her green card, everything that she had. And nobody can find that. I don't know where it is. That's disappeared. Now, if she had that written down somewhere on a piece of paper, it would have been in the paper, the papers that she gave my aunt. See, one thing, you can connect the dots. If I get law enforcement to pay attention, then they'll be able to connect the dots. Because the address is an old address. Even the boy doesn't know it. Because he's 17 and they lived there way more than 17 years ago. So she, you know, they haven't lived in that vicinity for a long time. But what I'm trying to say is that so she's mentioning my family a lot. Like she's mentioning members of my family a lot. I don't know what's her obsession. I don't know what's her obsession with me or my family. I don't know. I don't know I don't know if she's trying to do this. So she's trying to portray or mislead or make people believe that she has a mental problem and she doesn't know who she is. I think it's just a ruse that she and the boyfriend came up with to basically, you know, she's probably agreed to go in the hole for him, basically. To show love and loyalty to him. Because, you know, he's the man, she's the woman. She should know her place. Her job, she has one job, and that's to show loyalty to him. And I'm pretty sure he has convinced her as such. That's how they work. They're not just with me, but that's their lifestyle. Her job is to big him up, exalt him in front of people, and then take the blame for all the crap that he would come up with and they would do together. In the end, she takes all the responsibility. But hey, more power to her. If that's what she wants to do, all I can do is support that. All her family probably can do is support her at it. The point is, she has to kill me. So if he wants me, if he was the one and his family was attacking me and my family for a long time, then she's pretending, she's coming at me in a way. One, first, so I know I am being attacked. Secondly, I know it's her because there's no way I can mistake it. And no way I can mistake that it's, I think it's somebody else. Why would that be? If all of a sudden, why would that be? because this is what she wants me to know. Like, she agreed to take this responsibility on herself so that the boyfriend can get away with it. The boyfriend can get away with it. Whatever game they're playing, I don't know. I don't know what the game is. I have no idea what their game is. I don't know what their aim is and what their game is. I don't know. All I know is that I'm being bashed continually, and it's affecting the cat as well. And my life is an upheaval. I ran my ads. Like I said, I created, about 4 days ago, I created some new Google ad campaigns. I'm getting clicks on the ads, but nobody's reaching out to me, which I find odd. So I'm trying to lower the daily budget as low as I possibly can. And I'm hoping that some people start reaching out, because I really need to start getting back on my feet. It's not because I'm lazy. The amount of things that I've done for a year and a half to try to just to get my, you know, to get an income through my own business, I've not been lazy. I've tried really hard. But it's kind of hard when you're trying, you're not succeeding because you're doing something wrong. But when you're not succeeding because somebody else is either stealing the clients or just clicking on the ads and eating up the daily budget out of sheer maliciousness and spite. What else can it be? Sheer maliciousness and spite. Maybe they hate me because, you know, he hates me because I'm a woman and I'm more productive than he is. I don't know. I don't know what motivates his annoyance with me or his hatred. Because I thought she was being abused, right? But this, I'm sure from what I'm thinking, was happening way before that. So there is no reason at all, except he just can't stand productive women. Look at what she's doing for him. Look at what she's doing, right? The way how this all started, she's sitting around the house. It's like they wanted me to know that she's the one. Why would they do that? Why would they do that? People usually don't let people know who's behind it. Okay, they're banking on law enforcement is not going to pay attention to me. Law enforcement will think either I'm schizophrenic, a drug user, or both. But what if I did get someone to listen to me? What if they're wrong about that and somebody did listen and it fed right back to them? I don't think they're stupid enough to take that chance. They wanted me to know it was her. I have no doubt. They wanted me to know it was her. Why? Why would that be? Because they want to put all the blame on her. And if she wants to take it, then she'll take it. Because this doesn't make sense. So he probably doesn't, he don't like women who are productive. And he proceeds to relieve them of their funds. Like I always say that. Productive people annoys the shit out of them. Especially a woman who is productive. Because that just makes his loses an erection when he thinks of a woman being successful than he is. He's kind of like maybe one of those real macho men who believes because he has a pee-pee, he runs the world. Unless he uses his genitals to rule the world. I don't know. I don't know, men out there. Unless he uses his pee-pee to run the world. I don't know. But, you know, he probably can't stand the sight of a successful woman or somebody who at least when he tries to bring them down, they don't stay down. They try to get back up because they don't have time for that. They don't have time to sit and dawdle. There's bills to be paid. There's life to be lived. They don't have time to sit and dawdle and try to scam people and steal their money. They just want to get back up and get on their feet. But he probably can't stand a woman. People like that, especially a woman, he probably can't stand them. After all, if he's macho as I think he is, and chauvinistic as I think he is, from what he's doing to me, he would not be able to stand me even for 5 minutes. He wouldn't. He would not be able to stand me for 5 minutes. I'm like everything that he that makes him shameful. I'm a woman. I have inheritances. Of course, he has access to them. I don't. And thanks to her, he probably does. I don't know what kind of woman she is, but hey, whatever. They're a couple. They protect each other. So he has all my money, probably blocked me. You know, she's playing her game, whatever the fuck this voice, this skull thing is, I don't know. And now he's sicked around me like a dog, like a wild dog. He's sicked around me like a wild dog. And now this is where the gang stalkers come in. They're getting these people, these so-called gang stalkers, to mess with me and to make it look like, well, you know, they're like, it's the police, the FBI. And like I said, it's my firm belief that a lot of people get away. People like you and me get away with a lot of crimes because they go with this mode. They go through these channels. They hire these gang stalkers. Gang stalkers, there's a theme to us. To the gang stalkers, to our situation. The police is hard to really pay attention to it. They think we're either drunk, high, or schizophrenic, or all three. And it's so vague. It's kind of hard to prove. Like, you see somebody sitting out there. You call the police. By the time the police get here, they're gone. What are you going to say? They were sitting there? What's that going to do? It's not. I want to put cameras. I can't afford it. Because I don't know how much it costs per month to do that. If I could, though, I would, because it'll pick up all these clicks. These click, 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 and they'll know something is wrong. And the second thing is, how I know, you know, it's like all these things are tied into it. So I know they had something to do with it. I know they did. And I know that they're hacking extensively. I think they might have gotten a lot of money off of me and my family. Why they want to kill me now, I don't know. Like I said, did they do something to me? Are they afraid that there's somebody out there who will say something to me that's going to lead right back to them? I mean, I don't know. What could this possibly be? I don't know. I really don't know. But she mentions my family a lot, and she is targeting my family too as well. She's targeting my family. Well, we all have the same symptom where it feels like you're like on fire, you're burning. And the chest pains. It's like this raw, burning, blazing feeling in your chest, around your heart. You feel like you're like the raw rawness. I don't know how else to describe it. It just feels like that from the inside. Meaning, I don't know what's going on the inside. What if they're doing that to our heads? Hematomas. I don't know. Could it cause cancer? Could it cause aneurysms? Obviously, the technology exists to do these things. But in the wrong hands, for a person who don't really know to regulate it, or a person who does not have the person they're directing this energy on in best interest at heart, the consequences or the results can be dire or fatal. Because the doctor talks about monitoring patients with these technologies, but they know how to regulate it because they have done studies on how to regulate it. These have not. These are using the technology with the intention to kill people, to maim them, to hurt them, to injure them, to put them out of commission. These are not good people. Not good people. And that is the people who are doing this to me and to you. Not just me.